In this video, we'll be talking about the biotechnology and its applications. Biotechnology, as the name suggests, bio and the technology. This technology is being used, or the use of biology and technology, to solve the problems and make useful products. So it helps in actually making useful products. Now, if we wish to define biotechnology, it can be defined, or it is actually, it uses the cellular and biomolecular processes to develop technologies and products that help in improving our lives and health. So it is aimed at industrial production. It aims at industrial production of useful substances, such as bioactive molecules. Now, what are bioactive molecules? Bioactive molecules are those soluble molecules which are like hormones, cytokines, growth factors, immunosuppressant drugs, etc., which interact and help in the moderation of cell activity. So it helps in the production of bioactive molecules, that is there. Then also other products which are of great importance, such as biopharmaceuticals, genetically modified microbes, fungi, animals and plants. So there is a wide application of biotechnology. Now, if we talk about the fields of biotechnology where it is applicable, so there are different fields to it. That is, first, it can be used in therapeutics, in treatment of various kinds of diseases. Then, diagnostics. It can be very easily applicable to diagnose various problems related to humans and plants also. It can treat that. Then third is the GM crops, genetically modified crops, or we will study the genetically modified organisms. And it helps in incorporating, in the case of GM organisms, that is, if we say GM crops, that is in agriculture, or GMO, that is organisms, there is always, we want to incorporate desirable traits into these plants and animals. It is also useful in the field of processed food, which is now very, very common and is readily available in the market. So the use of biotechnology is there in processing of the food to increase the shelf life and to enhance or to maintain the nutritional value. Then it is bioremediation. Bioremediation, when we are talking, it is a process to treat the contaminated media such as the soil and water, etc., by stimulating the growth of microorganisms that degrade the pollutants. And we can also, with the help of biotechnology, we can incorporate those organisms to treat the waste, that is by targeting the specific pollutant. That means specific microorganisms can be designed to target specific pollutants. Then we have the waste treatment, where microorganisms again can be used for the treatment of the waste and the production of energy, which is again important. Production of energy. Also, biotechnology can be used for GM crops, like the genetically modified has been utilized to create tailor-made plants to supply alternative resources to industries in the form of starch, fuels and pharmaceuticals. So we can also write By creating tailor-made plants. So these are the various applications of biotechnology in different fields. From this we can get an idea that it is a field which can be applied to almost all the aspects. Now, when we talk of agriculture is very, very important, because even after the Green Revolution, it was not sufficient enough to meet the needs of the growing population. Also, there were many disadvantages to the process, like the use of the overuse of the chemicals and all that caused a lot of problems. Now, when we talk of the application in agriculture, obviously the main aim of the biotechnology is to increase the food production in the case of agriculture. Now, over here, when we talk of biotechnology in agriculture, there are obviously the three major steps to it. That means there are critical areas of research in biotech, that is providing the best catalyst, that may be mostly an improved organism, that microbes. So the basic is to provide best catalyst. The second important is creating a optimal condition for the catalyst action. So the second point is creating optimal condition for the catalyst action. And third is the downstream processing technologies. So downstream processing technologies. So the three areas, these are the critical areas of research for its use in agriculture or any other field, but it has to be providing the best catalyst. Mostly it is in the form of microbes, or that means to manipulate the gene, then creating the optimal condition for the catalyst action so that the desired gene can multiply properly, and downstream processing to harness the or to obtain the product. Now, coming to the agriculture, as discussing, the agriculture is, when we are talking of the biotechnology and its use in agriculture, to increase the food production is the aim of biotechnology. Now here, when we are talking of this, there are three options, that means three basic concepts for increasing the food production. The first is agrochemical based agriculture. So three thoughts are there. That is, first is agrochemical based agriculture. Now, what do you mean by agrochemical based agriculture? Agrochemical based agriculture, that is, it is the use of chemical fertilizers like herbicides, insecticides, etc. in agriculture. Now, the mixture of these active ingredients to obtain the desired effects and promote plant growth. Now, how biotechnology comes into picture? Biotechnology is used to reduce the allergens in food. They help in increasing the disease fighting nutrients in food. That means when we are talking of agrochemical based agriculture, it is actually the use of chemicals such as herbicides, pesticides, etc. in agriculture. But biotechnology, how does biotechnology come into picture? Because by using biotechnology, we can increase disease fighting nutrients in the food. That means we can incorporate those genes which help in providing a kind of food that is more nutritious, helps in building immunity. Other things is we can develop the pest resistant crops in this method, or we can reduce the allergens in food. That means the food will now be less allergic to many people. Then the second important point about the culture, this agriculture we are talking, is organic agriculture, which is also known as organic farming. Now, the organic farming relies on natural processes, that means which are not using any kind of chemicals, and that maintain and improve the fertility of the soil, the soil structure. It improves the biodiversity and reduce soil erosion. Also, this helps in reducing the risk of human, animal and environmental exposure to toxic material. So organic agriculture actually is in sync with the ecosystem. Then we are talking of the third point, that is the genetically engineered crop based agriculture. This is very, very important. That is genetically engineered crop based agriculture. Now, when we say genetically engineered crop based agriculture, they are also, the crops produced by such methods are known as GM crops or genetically modified crops. So it produces GM crops, in which we manipulate the genome of the plant. Now the genome, that is the DNA, has been modified or manipulated, and here we use genetic engineering methods. Various examples of plants such as soybeans, corn, then canola, cotton, apple, papaya are successfully modified and are being used. GM plants have been useful because when we are talking of GM plants are useful in many ways. Genetic modification actually has resulted in these crops to more tolerant to abiotic stresses. So GM crops are more tolerant to abiotic stress. Abiotic stress over here, when we are talking of the temperature change, the change in the pH, and the salt, that means the salinity, all these factors. So the plants are able, these are the advantages of GM crops. So they are more tolerant to abiotic stress. Secondly, GM crops are pest resistant. That means they are capable of avoiding the infection, or they reduce their dependence. That means the plants reduce their dependence on the use of chemicals, that is pesticides. Then the genetically modified crops are having post harvest losses are reduced. Post harvest losses means the plant growth is normally post harvest loss reduced. That means the yield is good. Then that is, they can have the more nutritional value. So they have increased nutritional value because they are already modified. So increased nutritional value. It is tailor-made, right? Also, there is, they have been utilized to have the more shelf value. That means they can have, GM crops can have more shelf value. Shelf value means they can be stored for a longer duration. So these are some of the major developments in agriculture and where the biotechnology has played an important role.